to Dr. Renee Sunday Show. Woo, we're so excited. I am Dr. Renee Sunday, and you know I'm the platform builder. So what we do is, here at the Dr. Renee Sunday Show, we bring you information that we can have awareness, I'm part of that too, education, and what we can make, what, wise decisions. You know, that's what we have to have. We have to have the information to be able to make wise decisions, right? We all have made mistakes in life, but we actually, we're going to get it right, okay? I am Dr. Renee Sunday, and you know I am the platform builder. So what I do is I help people identify their purpose if they're not aware. And then we build a platform, you know what it is, to be seen, be heard, and the ching-ching to get paid, right? That's what it's all about. My main things is podcasting, media. I love media, radio, TV, magazine, right? And also... Yeah. Publishing. Get that book out. Get the book out. Get it out. But I also coach people in regards to business, tactics, strategies, and also nonprofit. And, of course, I am a woman of God, so you know everything I do, you know, okay? It's going to be on the real, real. But we love you here. First, we want to stop for a minute and say thank you for loving us and believing in us. Here at the Dr. Renee Sunday Show, everything that we do, you support us and things that we do. So we want to say thank you for that, okay? All right. Now, we want to bring our amazing guest. First of all, she's a great supporter of the brand. I mean, the things, everything that we do on our brand, when I'm speaking, our social media, she's very supportive, Miss Yolanda Daniels. She just supports us, even our drop shipping. She's just a very supportive person, and we love her dearly here at the Dr. Renee Sunday Show. But she actually, she don't play, okay? She's actually in the final stages of obtaining her paralegal. Yeah, she's gonna be getting y'all straight, right? And she has some amazing daughters. She has a granddaughter. She just have a wonderful family. All of us have a life story, right? So she's going to glean on that a little bit and tell us some things that how, you know, no matter how we start, no matter what we go through, we actually can make it and do what the purpose that we were created to do. So not to delay, we have the amazing, phenomenal young lady herself. We have Miss Yolanda, if I can say her name right, Yolanda Daniels. Welcome to the Dr. Renee Sunday Show. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Wow.
Yes,
I'm
here.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. Well, I actually just finished the paralegal study, and I'm waiting on graduation, so they're finalizing the details on that. So they said maybe the 1st of March, and it will be local, Macon, Georgia. So I'm waiting on the graduation ceremony. And thinking of going back.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Uh-huh. And going back to school to study the criminal justice, kind of stay in the justice field. And hopefully once I complete that, I'm thinking about business administration. But first I got to finish out the criminal justice, the justice field, and get all my degrees and diplomas with that, and hopefully the business administration. And see where that goes from there and build my resume. And I don't know what else, but it's just that justice, I just have a passion for justice because of my childhood. But like you said, all of us go through something, parents go through something, and we can't define and get to the root of it. But I know my future, my kids' future, are going to be better than my childhood, hopefully. And by doing that, hoping that it gets better and better for them by me setting justice so that people would not intervene on them, disturb them. And but you have people that's standing out there that's waiting to distract them, knock them off focus, and they end up backsliding, just confused and don't know which way to go, and that's what I'm trying to do, keep them from falling back to where they be wondering what happened to them. They was on this straight path, and then they go to wondering what happened, what did I do wrong? They have to walk back to move forward, and I can't stand them going through what I went through. So that's why I'm trying to build this platform revolving around the justice system. So we need justice.
That is
more
so
than
powerful.
Anything, we need justice.
Yes. Let me step back a minute and ask you this, because as the world does the world, you know, the world gonna, you know, things happen in the world, you know. This is probably a very touching question for you. What do you think what we are in regards of justice of things? I mean, you know, it's always been a separation. And let's just be real, ladies and gentlemen. It's always been a separation when it comes to color. It's always been a separation when it comes to gender. And you know, of course, economically. And, you know, that's what the United States specifically, in our preamble that's up there in the United States and every government building, saying it's justice for all, right? So tell me, what do you think we are now with so much technology in the world in regards of having justice?
Well, with the color situation, the black and the white situation, I'm African American, but you know, we have our, like I tell my daughter, we had a biased people and you had a prejudiced people. I consider myself biased, but in that category where you have some blacks that are dirty, black people, then you have some black that are biased. They're not against their own color, but they're biased of the way that the other blacks may talk, communicate, say their words. They might not say professional word, but they'll say trashy words that you don't like to comprehend. And you have some blacks that speak professional. They don't say that trashy stigma, you know, try to stigmatize a person, stereotype a person. So I consider those people dirty people in a category of being trashy and stereotyping them. So it's not about this. I'm black, but I don't like black people. It's, I'm African American, but I don't like trashy people that say certain words or dress a certain way or maybe drive a certain car with stuff on it, rims and things like that. And, you know, like street, their street, and they have their language, their gang-related things like that, tattoos, piercing. That's not me against them. It's just that I might be biased because I feel like that's street gang related. And with that being said, we deal with a lot of gang related type issues like sex trafficking, things like that. But I know there might be whites that do it too, but you have your white people that may be biased against their color too, which they don't have any color, but against the whites. But it's not that we're prejudiced or against them. It's just that I don't like tattoo piercing and I don't like certain language, communication-wise.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't mean no harm to them. It's just that when they say certain words, I just don't really want to communicate with them, talk to them.
And
that's what I'm
trying to
straighten out with my kids.
I understand, you're right. A lot of different environments, different people, and of course, ladies and gentlemen, we're not passing any judgment. But the thing about it is, everybody has to walk their own walk. Everyone has had an experience in life. And a lot of times the way we respond, the way we do things is what we've been through and what the environment that we've been in. We're not saying that the choices that you've made, everybody that has a tattoo, everybody that has these certain type of way that they dress. No, we're not, that is not what she's saying. But a lot of times you have to make your own choices because everyone has their own calling, everyone has their own purpose. But you have to kind of think about what you're representing. And the thing that I do personally, now this is a personal thing, I know, and now, you know, of course when we were all young, we did things, right? But as I know now that certain things that I do, a lot of things that I do, I know that I'm being watched. And not saying that I'm being watched, I do something different, but I know I do things unto God. So I know certain things that I do, and I want to represent him, and I want to represent my brand, the Sunday brand. So you have to kind of be mindful of the things that you do and say, and everybody can make their own decision. That's a great thing that God created us, that we are what's called a free moral agent, that we can actually, guess what, make our own decisions. But you have to be able to, whatever decision, know the pros and cons of making that decision. So I understand what you're saying, Yolanda, about that. Mm-hmm. But let me ask you, in regards of paralegal, what the things that we have that's going on out there in criminal justice, how do you like the technology that you guys probably reviewed some of that amazing information about technology, how it has actually helped a lot of people get acquitted or get out of jail, not having their life sentence, because the technology has played a great role, if you will, of making, you know, evidence, you know, that we didn't even notice we didn't have the evidence, or it actually has proven that wasn't the person that they thought it was. So what's your take on the amazing technology that we have now in this world that is helping the criminal justice, the departments in regards of making a decision about, you know, any kind of situation?
Well, they use technology for investigations, which is saying how to get acquitted. You can use it for investigation. You have the wiretap, and I think they tap your phone. They can come in on your social media, but they have to have a court order to investigate with the technology. And with the technology, like I said, a wiretap, they tap phones, they can tap your computer, they can hack your social media page to see if you're doing criminal activities. That's what the technology is about. And then they have the e-discovery, where, like, they use social media. And with social media, like, you use yours for a platform, but you have people that own that will hack you and will hack any social media page, and some people use it to spam. And then you have people that with spam, they call it the catfish, things like that. So technology, there's a lot going on with technology. I get what you're saying, but they tap it, they can wiretap it, but they have to have a court order. But you have some people that'll hack your page and use it for their own use. Then you have the investigators that'll come in and, I guess, wiretap it, and they investigate to see if you're doing criminal activities.
Technology has really advanced a lot of things, but, you know, and I think we have to, since you have kids as well, we have to make sure we educate our children in regards of, you know, social media. What advice do parents have in regards of their kids of kind of, advising them of what to do and what not to do on social media? What are your advice in regards of that?
Well, like with my kids, if someone stirring me in the public area, like maybe at work or something like that, I try to warn, like, my youngest daughter, don't accept friend requests, or if someone saying certain things that you don't like, maybe distraction, I just tell them, unfollow them, don't share certain things onto their page, but mostly unfollow this person, and, you know, stop our communications with them, because if they're stirring up drama with me and in the natural world, they'll come on social media and stir up with the children too. But I can't tell. They're 18, 20, and 23. And if they're jumping from one page, got this page with me, then they're creating another page, and then I see my kids on that page. I don't know how I'm coming across that page. I tell them, don't follow them, don't share nothing from their page to her page and stuff like that. And, like, with certain kids that maybe in her grade, maybe in their classes or whatever, if they're talking to them on Facebook and they're talking to them on the phone, I try to tell them, put it on mute, because I could be on a, I can be having a conversation on the phone or having a conversation with my daughter, and I don't want them to hear, because what I'm trying to do and what they're doing to my children is try to stir a drama where I feel like they may be trying to stir her up where she can't concentrate in school.
Right.
And
that's true.
That's why I tell her don't communicate with certain people, and don't, you know, if you're on the phone, please mute it, because if I walk in and I'm talking and you're on the phone, mute it or tell them where you call them back, because I think that they're trying to see what I'm doing at home and try to stir me up when I come out, like attack me with things that I've been on said to my daughter. It's just, I'm trying to figure out. And when I'm having a conversation with them, I think they record me sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't, but see, what I'm saying to them is trying to help them, not hurt them.
Right.
Trying to help them,
right,
for their future. But you have people, right, they record me and they sending it around to other people. I'm like,
mm-hmm,
why are you doing that? Why are you recording me and forwarding to people that I don't even communicate, like my family? Like, why are you doing that?
Right.
You stirring up,
right,
more drama. But you, and
right,
then she,
right,
see that. She's seeing that I don't go around this person, this relative, that relative, and that relative, and I just go to work and I come home, pay my bill, mind my business. I talk,
mm-hmm,
to who I talk, mm-hmm, to on the phone. And if I'm not going around them, it's a reason. But she don't, they don't,
right,
have to record what I say.
That's right. That's right. Well, you know, that's amazing. You know, people, you have to kind of accept people where they are. I've learned that. It's no rhyme or reason sometimes why people do and say things. What we're saying, ladies and gentlemen, is please be mindful, especially young people. Let me say this. Be real mindful. Try not to go places by yourself. I mean, you see that the trafficking is wide open. I mean, it's crazy. Go with somebody together. At least let somebody know where you are. You know, even when you do the different transportations, make sure you know people know where you are. And kids, we as parents, you know, I don't have kids, but I have several God kids. We just love you guys. We want you not to go through the things that we've gone through. So we want you to be safe. We're not trying to not allow you to have fun in life and enjoy life. We just want you to be safe. That's pretty much what we're saying. Yolanda, this is what I'm going to, you know, time goes by so quickly here. Tell us, you said that in regards of now the criminal justice that you're going to, and then business administration, can you speak a little bit and encourage someone? Because a lot of people want to go back to school. You know, they may have been out several years. Kind of say some points, if you can, to encourage someone that they can do like you, go back to school, that they can actually still work and then take some classes if it's in person or if it's online, but not to allow, you know, your circumstances or the things that you're going through to stop them. You know, just take it one step at a time like you're doing so wonderfully. So tell us a little bit of encouragement with that, and then after that, tell us how we can actually contact you on social media to support you in the things that you're doing.
Well, with the school, I started back going to school in 2017. I started going to work in 2018, and I just finished in 2019 with the paralegal studies. And with that being said, to encourage someone about going to school and working at the same time and having this platform on Facebook is to be careful what you put on Facebook, because a lot of people are doing the things that you're against. And by you being against it and you working in a public area, they're going to attack you, because, see, justice and criminals, that's the thing. You got, it's criminal justice, but you have some criminals that are seeking justice because they're innocent. Then you have some people that are not innocent and you're posting things on Facebook that you're against, and you have those criminals that are actually doing the things that you're against, they're going to attack because you're telling the truth. And like I tell people, it don't concern them. What happened to me when I was 18 years old until now is what I'm trying to uproot. And see, it's about sex trafficking. What happened to me being 8 years old and sodomized when I was eight until adulthood don't concern certain people. But when I post it on fake social media, people get offended because they're doing the same thing. And as I see people every day on social media, they're posting things that are occurring now that happened to me. And I'm like, I can relate to that, but I haven't gotten into the details of what actually happened to my childhood. And that's the thing that, like, the girl, the Nitra gun, what happened to her? And see, you have to refrain from saying certain things on social media because people are doing those things right up under our nose. And they're going to attack. They attack me to where sometimes I may not can't think straight, and I have to just get myself together, meditate for a moment. But, you know, that could be a person that needs help. But the school, going back to school, Millamont is a good school. I mean, they encourage me. I be on the phone with them maybe twice out the week, and I talk to them every day for 7 days. I be in a chat, in a discussion for 7 days a week. And I get tired, and when I feel like it's an interesting topic, I take it to my social media page because I feel like someone can learn something from this, like I'm learning. But the thing is, what I'm telling in my discussion, I don't discuss it on social media sometimes. Because if I'm getting attacked because of my social media page, it's because something is going on out there in this world that's surrounding me that maybe needs my attention, or they're trying to get me to be quiet.
Mm-hmm.
But with the statutes of limitations of Georgia, if I could go back 30-something years back and have those people arrested and investigated like my parents should have done. And see, with the world and technology now, people are having these people investigated, locked up, charged, and sent to prison for sodomizing their child or killing their child, raping their child. They are getting charged with the crime. But the thing that my parents didn't do, they didn't have it investigated until it was too late, until I got to the probably third assailant. But the other three or whatever, the first one, I guess they couldn't find who did it or whatever. But the thing is, nowadays, people are having these people charged, arrested for their crimes. And for that, I applaud the parents for doing that, for having these people arrested, having the justice system doing their job. Because back in the early 1980s, my parents, that's what they lacked. They didn't have it investigated. They just let it just happen. And it went on up until now, almost 40 years old. The same thing go on and on and on. And I tell people, I'm alone. I mind my business. But you have people out there that attack you, try you, and things like that, and then they'll crush you. So that's why I'm saying the justice, I'm trying to get to where I can just go forward to the court or whatever and have people, you know, they just need to be arrested for their crime because it's trafficking. It's sex trafficking.
Right.
And I'm not out there deliberately just, I'm just going to pick on this person, pick on that person, and just, I'm not doing that. They're doing that to me, and I'm like, why? So I'm saying they must want me to be quiet, but I'm telling them it don't concern them.
Right. That's right. That's right. Wow. Yeah, everybody has a voice. So, yes, we commend you for having your voice. We commend you for being a paralegalist and then also continue your journey with criminal justice and going on further with that with business administration. Tell us how we can contact you of course, ladies and gentlemen, she'll bench out who needs to be that she will further the conversation with. How can we contact you on social media?
They'll have to message me on social media. I can't get my phone number out because, like I said, we have.
Only give what's your name on social media. That's it. That's all we need. No phone number.
It's Yolanda Yannette Daniels on social media, and some people have that nickname, Lambda.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, we want to thank you so much for being here with us. Thank you, first of all, for being in your purpose. And then we want to say also thank you for taking time out and being here with us on the Dr. Renee Sunday Show.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Yolanda is amazing. It's a very transparent conversation that we had. The key is she wants you to know, and we want you to know, that you do have a voice. And we have, the things we used to do, it because, you know, I'm from the South. They used to say what happened in the house, stay in the house, like Las Vegas, what stay in Las Vegas. But we actually do have a voice. We do have a voice of what's going on in your life. And it's help out there. It's help. But we actually need to make sure we do it in a safe way. To get help, because if you tell, you know, we didn't get into this in the conversation, but if you get, you know, if you share the information kind of with the wrong person, and sometimes that's a learning curve, it could actually make the situation worse or nothing will happen. I mean, sometimes that happens. But, you know, there are trusted people out there that you can talk to. I'm a big component of counseling, you know, to work through the things that has happened in your life. Things that have happened in around you, maybe not directly, but indirectly, things that have happened in the world that can affect you and you're not even related to the person, okay? I can tell you firsthand when 9/11 happened. I can tell you exactly what I was doing, and so I knew as a counselor certain things that I had to do before that actually changed my whole life, and I know it changed a lot of people's whole life, but people were pulling on me to help them counsel them, so I had to actually use my own techniques and the own things that God has bestowed on me as a counselor. So, you know, as we always say, you're your best patient in a way. You need to be able to use those tactics to help you get out of the situation, so you could actually help somebody else. So you guys contact Yolanda and support her in the things that she's doing. We thank her for taking time out and being in the schedule, being here of her schedule, rather, to be with us. You know, mental health is real. So contact us if you need to contact a counselor. I'm a counselor myself, but I have a directory of people that I trust, that I know your information won't end up on social media or somewhere else publicly. Amen. I'm going to just say amen on that, right? Amen.
Okay.
And so the thing about it is, if you want to be a guest on our platform, you know how to contact us. If you want to start your own podcast, your own magazine, your own television show, publish your book, you know, contact us at ReneeSunday.com. That's Renee, R-E-N-E-E, Sunday, SUNDAY.com. We want you to remember you do have a calling. You do have a reason you are born. We have to do three things. We have to believe, we have to trust, and we have to walk it out. And we have to don't stop. We have to get it. And what are we getting? We're getting our purpose, and we're getting our purpose now. So we have to believe, trust, and walk it out, okay? So whatever you said to yourself, come on, you're not a mistake. You're not a mistake, okay? No matter what somebody else has said, no matter what you're saying to yourself, you're not a mistake. We love you here at the Dr. Renee Sunday Show. We'll see you next time. We love you, love you, love you. And look, you can't do nothing about it. We'll see you next time, all right? All right, bye-bye.